bring the Bible dictionary into this. And the words Christmas, it says the anniversary of birth of Christ, and it's observed and celebrated by most Protestants and by the Roman Catholics on December the 25th and by Eastern Orthodox churches on January 6th. It says right here the first mention of its observance on December the 25th is in the time of Constantine. Yes, because he's the one that started. About 325 AD, the date of the birth of Christ is not known. The word Christmas is formed of two words, Christ and Mass. Our temples that our ancestors left us can give us evidence of this. Now, Ka meant spirit. In ancient times, we called it Ka. When the Gnostics got it, it was called Kares, that the Greeks called Christ. The symbol were two arms up, meaning Ka, your spirit. Mass meant birth. So what we have here, when we go back to Bible dictionary, Christ's mess was formed from Kares, and Mass was formed from mess, that means birth. That literally means, literally, spiritual birth. Romans didn't understand this. They thought that a physical body, this is the basis and foundation of Western Christianity, would get up out that grave and go to heaven. Right. They tell you in Western Christianity that your decomposed body will get up out that grave. This body is going back to the earth to feed everything else in the earth. But it's your spirit that's going to go through a metamorphosis that our ancestors taught. So Ka, Kares, that meant mess, meaning spiritual birth that you carved on the temples thousands of years ago. So the Amsu, Asar in the form of the risen Heru, which was a symbol of the cross. So the cross, as you see Asar here, where he's going through Sekhet Hetepu in the spiritual realm, but he's got to go through a metamorphosis. We see the Ka or the Kares has to go through a process first. He has to become a Christ, brothers and sisters. Nothing but taking no white Jesus. But it was a spiritual pilot that had to evoke within him. So the mummification process that you see here, notice the Amsu was a symbol that was used in the mummification of the cot that we call mummy. X meant resurrection. All right? So it's a spiritual resurrection, and as a process of the body is called the caressing, which is the mummification of the body. So when you see on the temples, you'll see two symbols called the Amsu and the X means of Heru that meant the spiritual resurrection. To become one with the Asar, the first Christ over 10,000 years ago, that to rise up your spirit, your caress that I'm going to show in a second. So when we go to King Tutankhamun's tomb, here you see in the Gospels where it speaks of how one is able to, Jesus made one see again. He made one talk again, live again. That was based off of the opening of the mouth. They didn't understand it was about the spiritual body in the afterlife to see again, to speak again. The Romans, again, did not understand spirituality. So here you see the Sim priest goes through the opening of the mouth of Asar, or King Tutankhamun, who's going to become one with Asar. So it says right here, through the opening of the mouth ceremony that I put here, at the time of the mummification of the body, the raised up of the coming of the what? Kares Christ. All right? The spiritual body. Now, goes on to say, Asar was the Netter, that we call God today, of the resurrection, the judge of the dead, the Lord of eternity, through the divine Kares body. So that's what they're doing right here, is becoming one with Asar in the afterlife. This was based off of the opening of the mouth ceremony that was taken and ended up in the Gospels as we know it today. So the Kareheb Sim priest, mummification of the Sahu's spiritual body, was a process, brothers and sisters. This process was due to the fact that they observed nature and saw that a caterpillar crawled on the ground and it formed into a cocoon. A metamorphosis took place, and what happened? A butterfly. So they saw a spirit would leave the body through a process of metamorphosis. This was called the caressing that we call the Ka. When you go to Ethiopia, you see the black Yeshua here in Ethiopia. They have the truth on their paintings in their churches. So when you see Yeshua here being now wrapped up in the mummy for his caressing, for him to become a Christ, through the mummification of the body. Why do you always see the European Jesus wrapped up like a mummy? This was called the caress. In ancient Kemet, we took the cot that they call mummy today, and we wrapped it up to preserve the body for the Sahu. What is the Sahu? The Sahu is the spiritual body to rise up and ascend to heaven. White folks didn't know anything about no spiritual knowledge. They thought the body would just get up and walk up to heaven. That's right.